So I've had two and a half or three conversion type experiences with Christians trying to change me from being trans and being a lesbian into being a guy and being straight. And I'm going to try and talk about them. So the first one was when I was with a independent Methodist church, which were like a home church almost, called Kingsway, and they were linked to a bigger church, which were in Sale, in the north. And an elder started inviting me back to his house for prayer. The church elders were concerned about me and so on and so forth. So I went a couple of times for prayer, and every time I did, he would lay me down on my back and put his hand on my forehead and start commanding in Jesus' name that the demons come out and the demons of femininity come out. And yeah, he would then start talking over me about Jesus' healing power, and quoting scripture, and so on and so forth at me. I was about 14, I think, at the time. So I didn't really fully understand what was going on, only it was quite scary, but it was good to get the attention from someone who was very high in the church as well. But as it went on, it got scarier. This happened about three times over a period of a few months, and that was probably the mildest of the three experiences. The next time, I'd been thrown out of home and I joined the Jesus Army, because the Jesus Army was better than the street. And I also believed that I was doing God's work at the same time. And basically, I was at a farmhouse, a community farmhouse. I lived in community, near their farm, near Daventry. And there was a load of brothers there, including some quite senior shepherds. Shepherds as in that they're quite senior in the church, and they shepherd disciples as opposed to shepherds and sheep, although I suppose the analogy still carries. Anyway, we'd just eaten, and this guy called Chris Conqueror and this other guy, Andy, I can't remember his virtue name, pinned me down in the kitchen. In fact, I got into the garden, they walked me in from the garden and then pinned me down in the kitchen, putting one hand on each arm. Then two senior elders, Mike, and I can't remember the name of the other guy, came and lay hands on my forehead with me pinned to the floor, and started praying and yelling in Jesus' name that the demon of femininity would be bound, that anything that wasn't of God would leave right now. And this went on for about two and a half hours with me crying and screaming and yelling at people and getting pinned harder and harder to the floor. And they're using oil as well, so annoying me. And this happened twice, the exact same experience before I left the Jesus Army. I got to the point that it got in my head, the peer pressure of it all, that I started going up to the front all the time for prayer because I felt there was something evil about me. I felt that feeling the way I did about girls and wanting to be with a girl as a girl and wanting to be a girl was obviously something demonic. So I started going up for prayer all the time and getting slain in the spirit at the front of the church, and so on and so forth, and really starting to believe that there's something really seriously wrong with me. So that's my experience with the Jesus Fellowship, Jesus Army, whatever you want to call them. And then the third one's more mild. St. Catherine, no, not St. Catherine, sorry, St. Peter's, I think they're called, in Brighton. I've had brothers come up to me and say, "Can I pray for you?" And I say, "Yes." And I'm dressed as a girl and everything. They start praying for me and they're like, "God, show this man how powerful he can be within you. Show this man how wrong his current path is and how you've got a virtuous path laid out for him," and so on and so forth. And these are just normal members of the church. And they do this in the open, in the open church. Anyway, that's all I've got to share. I hope this is useful to someone. Okay, bye.